Hello VSDC family! In the recent VSDC 9.3 update, we have improved our wizard, designed for creating slideshows. And now we are excited to show you all about it. Ready? Let's dive in! First, let's talk about how to access the wizard. There are two ways to do this. The first is from the main screen. Launch the video editor and click on the Create Slideshow button. Then enter and confirm your project parameters. The second method works if you already have a project open. Just go to the Editor tab, click on the first icon on the left that features a magic wand and is labeled Run Wizard. If you've already added files to the timeline, you can select them, open the drop-down under Run Wizard, and choose Edit Object Sequence to transfer your files to the wizard. Now, let's explore the wizard interface. On the left, you'll see the template panel with transitions. Next to it is the preview panel, showing how the selected transition looks. On the right is the main preview panel, displaying your slideshow. Below, you will find the sequence panel, which works as a simplified timeline. To start creating, add files to the Sequence panel by dragging them from the Object Explorer. Once added, we can start editing. The tools above the Sequence panel allow you to rotate, crop, cut, split, and apply quick styles for color adjustments. For images, you can set the duration in the field next to those tools. Simply enter the desired duration and press Enter, or click on the green check mark next to it to confirm. For videos, it is not possible to set the duration in the same field, but you can trim them. Just click on the scissors icon to open the cutting and splitting window and remove unnecessary video parts. If cropping borders leads to black bars, hold Shift while cropping to maintain the original aspect ratio. Alternatively, to match the scene's aspect ratio, click the arrow next to Set the Original Size in the lower left corner of the cropping window and select Set Size in accordance with the scene's aspect ratio, set the maximum size. If this method doesn't work as expected, for instance, if it crops important parts of the picture or video, you can leave the file's original size and blur its background. To do this, open the file's properties by clicking on the rightmost icon in the toolbar above the Sequence panel. Then click on the file's name in the Object Explorer and find the Fill Background option in the Properties window. In the Object Explorer, you can also add audio and video effects. Simply click on Click here to add effects and select the effects you want. If needed, you can also reorder your files in the Sequence panel. To move a file, click and drag it to the desired position. The files will swap places. You can also use the green buttons in the toolset to do this. To delete a file, click the red cross below the file. Let's move on to transitions. Ensure that the Download Templates Automatically option is enabled at the bottom left of the window, so templates are ready to use right away. To apply a transition, drag and drop it from the template panel into the gray transition area between files, or click on the transition area and select Add Transition above the sequence. Use the Select All button to apply the same transition to all cells. Just open the drop-down, click on Select All Transitions, and drag a template to any cell. To remove a transition, click on its cell and press the Remove button from the sequence. For removing all transitions, open the drop-down under the Remove button and select Remove All Transitions. You can also add random transitions by clicking a transition cell, opening the drop-down under Add Transitions, and choosing Add a Random Transition or Add Random Transitions to All Files. In the Preview window, you can check how individual fragments or transitions look or view the whole project. To preview the full composition, press Play All. Use the arrow buttons to navigate between files. Once you're satisfied with the slideshow, click on Apply Settings to add it to the timeline. You can then add music if desired. To make changes, select the slideshow on the timeline. Click on the drop-down menu under Run Wizard and choose Edit Object Sequence. After finalizing your adjustments, review your settings and export the project. And that's it for today. What do you think about our improved wizard? For more details about it, check out the link to our how-to article in the description. Do not forget to subscribe for more videos. Bye!